How does the computer synthesize speech?
Well, our machine takes any ASCII text, that's the way text information is stored in a computer, and converts that to intelligible speech. It first looks at the words, decides which phonemes are in those words. Phonemes are the basic elements of speech. It puts the phonemes together for the words. It massages them to make sure that they flow the way natural speech does. And then that's converted to a set of parameters for a speech synthesizer, which then produces speech.
When you say a phoneme, tell me more about it. You say that's the basic building block of speech. What is a phoneme, literally?
A phoneme is a short sound in speech. It's the fundamental element such that if a phoneme changes, it changes the meaning of a word. Phonemes are, you can roughly think of them as being vowels or fricative sounds, sounds, and a number of other sounds. There are roughly 38 to 45 phonemes in English, depending on which linguist you speak, you're talking to. And in other languages, there are roughly the same number.
Does your product cover all of the English language?
Yes, our product takes unrestricted text and converts it to English.
What size of a computer do you need to do that?
It's based on a commercially available 16-bit microcomputer chip.
When you say converts it to English, now suppose I were to type in French words.
It would attempt to pronounce them, but they probably wouldn't come out right because our phoneme models are for English and the phonemes in French are different.
Yeah, with an English accent.
So this particular device is language dependent. It's programmable in one particular
language
with its particular set of phonemes.
Also, the pronunciation rules, not only the phonemes, but the way the phonemes flow together are different in different languages. So in our device, we have not only models of the phonemes, but we have the pronunciation rules as well.
So that sort of helps the sentence come out in context
if it were spoken. With reasonably natural inflection.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. You said not only it recognizes the phonemes and then it massages those to turn it into normal speech. What do you mean by massaging it?
Well, what happens when you speak, you don't normally articulate everything. For instance, if you were giving directions to someone, you would say, make a left turn at the corner. You don't say make a left turn at the corner. So things are strung together in normal speech. And in fact, some sounds are not spoken at all in certain words. And there's rules for how you adjust the phonemes depending on what sound came first and what sound came afterwards. And also you need to know where the sound appears within a word and in fact where it appears within a sentence to make sure that you get the inflection proper.
Does manipulation of the phonemes also include volume and inflection, or is that done separately?
Yes, it includes the stress. It includes a phoneme isn't a fixed element. It starts at one point and it flows to another point depending on which sound comes next.
Carl, earlier when Herb and I were talking, we used the phrase speech synthesis, and that's different, isn't it, from speech coding? What's the difference and what does this do?
Okay, the way to think of it is we call this synthesis by rule, because there is no pre-recorded speech or no stored speech in this device. It takes text and it produces speech according to the pronunciation rules of English. Okay, the other kind of speech, what people think of as speech synthesis, is synthesis by analysis, where the information is recorded from a human voice and then compressed or processed in some other manner by a computer so that it can be stored, and then it is simply reconstructed. There's no knowledge of what the words were, what they mean, or how they flow together. It's a sophisticated tape recording process, if you will.
Okay, Carl, I feel like there's been food on the plate, and I'm waiting for permission to eat it. Now, let's hear what this thing does.
Okay, let's. We created a few sentences before. We'll try one of those.
Okay. Describe what you're doing.
Okay,
what
I've done here is with this little keyboard, I've stored some messages ahead of time by typing them in, and here's one.
Hi, Stuart. Hi, Herb. thanks for the opportunity to appear on Computer Chronicles.
Okay, so now you had just typed that phrase in before on the keyboard.
That's right. I can type anything on this keyboard and it will then speak it.
Okay, now, again, going back to Herb's phone situation, are we looking actually at the thing you call call text?
That's right.
Now?
That's right.
Okay, now suppose I had an electronic message left for me in my computer, and I could I then call it up on a telephone
exactly.
and ask the computer to read that file to me over the phone?
Exactly. That's
okay,
the basic.
Could you demonstrate something like that for
sure,
me?
Sure, we have another message in here like that.
Stuart, we have rescheduled the taping to 4:30 this afternoon. See you then, Rod.
Okay, so that's a message from Ron. Again, if you were at your terminal to receive an electronic mail message, you could access that at your terminal. But if you were on the road and you stopped at a gas station and you wanted to find out what messages were left for you, you can call up a call text system and it will read your electronic mail to you over the phone. You made the point earlier, Herb, that there are many voice terminals in the world called telephones, but they don't hook up to a digital machine. Well, now they do, and you can, in fact, access any text database over the telephone in voice.
How large is the market for accessing databases via the telephone? Is that a new area that's just opening up, or a lot of people doing it?
Well, it's a new application. At this point in time, there are no commercial online applications of that, though we are talking to most of the major electronic mail suppliers about the potential of this. It's a new feature. The capability heretofore has not been available, and in fact the call text product line was introduced just at the end of last year, at the end of 1983, that is.
Carl, you played back a couple of messages which you had typed in earlier. I'd like you to actually type something in for me now so I can see how quickly you can turn a sentence into spoken speech.
What would you like to say?
I'll just say we have about a minute left to do this.
Okay. We have a minute left to do that. We have... wait a minute. I'm in the wrong mode here. Excuse me just a moment.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Now I have less than a minute, but we'll do it anyway. We have... less than a minute to do this.
We have less than a minute to do this.
And it spoke very quickly. I appreciate
yeah, right.
that.
In fact, right along. we can adjust the speaking rate also.
One last question before sure. we have to take a break. Now, what is the product we're talking about? Is it this big blue box, or
no,
can I do something with my PC to accomplish this?
This is the product that's actually speaking. Okay, this board goes in an IBM personal computer, and this board contains the text-to-speech conversion equipment that's here. This is the microprocessor that is doing most of the controlling. It also has a telephone interface, which is the front end of the board. And in fact, it has what's called an RS-232 port, which is the kind of port that you have on the back of a terminal. So in fact, this port, looking at a computer, looks like a terminal, and the computer thinks it's talking to a terminal. This port, you've probably seen that, looks like a telephone. So, in fact, looking in from the telephone network, we have a telephone here, a computer terminal here, and the mechanism to convert text to speech.